All right, on Hot Copy this morning, branding himself as the crusader for senior citizens, election lawyer Romulo Macalintal is seeking a Senate seat in the upcoming elections. What are his plans should he win? He joins us in the studio this morning. Romy Mac, thank you so much for coming to the show.
Hey, you've joined
all the debates, so I want to really focus on certain issues when it comes to you.
Okay.
You're wearing the shirt One Catholic Vote. You have over 100 lay leaders of the People's Choice Movement choosing you as their candidate. First of all, is there a Catholic vote?
Ako'y naniniwala na mayroong Catholic vote. Ano ha? Hindi nga lamang nagsasalita ang mga Katoliko tungkol dito, pero sa panahon ito, sa aking palagay, naririyan yan. Ano? Yung tinatawag nating silent majority, marami yung mga Katoliko dito. Itong pagdadala ko ng One Catholic Vote na ito, hindi para sabihin na ako'y kumakandidato under this advocacy, kundi para lang patunayan na gusto ko ng ating mga Katoliko'y magsama-sama tayo, tayo magkaisa.
Now, but then, would you label yourself as a conservative?
Yes, konserbatibo tayo kasi talagang tayo naniniwala sa ating reliyon. Nais ko yung paglaban yan. Kahit noong una pa man, ipinaglalaban ko yan.
So if you win a Senate seat, will your faith determine the bills and the laws you want passed?
Not necessarily. I will always be guided by the practicability of the bill, the good that it could do to our country.
Okay.
Ano bang magagawa nito para sa ating bansa? Hindi laban dahil sa aking reliyon, kundi para sa lahat. Ano,
so you believe in the separation of church and state?
Oh yes, because that is precisely provided for in our constitution,
okay,
that there is a separation between the church and the state, that even the constitution says that there cannot be any law that would establish just one religion and no funds could be extended by the government to a particular religion.
All right. In 2010, this is quite interesting, when the RH bill was being fought, you know, you had pro and against. Well, now it is the RH law. At the Manila Cathedral in 2010, of course, in an article I read, you were labeled as a conservative and you actually confronted supporters of the RH bill in 2010. Why did you do that?
Were
you against the RH bill?
Yeah, we were against the RH bill, and we did not really confront the supporters of the RH bill. I just requested them to keep silent while a mass was going on inside the cathedral.
So
hindi ko po sila pinatatanggal doon, kundi nagmimisa nung oras na yun at sila'y nagsisigawan sa labas.
So in other words, ang tanong ko, kung senador si Romy Mac, nakita nyo naman ang labanan, would you have voted for the RH bill to become law?
No, I would have voted against it, sapagkat ako ay naniniwala na hindi pa nararapat yun para sa ating bansa.
Do you consider the use of condoms, pills, do you see that as a sin?
No, not as a sin. As a matter of fact, even the Pope was very liberal in the use of condom. No? If the condom is being used for medical purposes to prevent...
Let's say HIV AIDS.
Yeah, HIV cases, then I would go for it. And so, as a matter of fact, even the Pope was in favor of that in those kind of cases.
So are you trying to say that if a husband uses a condom, let's say so that his wife will not get pregnant again, you consider it a sin?
No, not really a sin, but it's not within the policy over the church.
So then that's why I asked. You said you believe in the separation of church and state, and yet all your reasoning so far is what the church believes.
Yes,
but what do you believe?
Sa akin paniniwala,
what is best for the people?
What is best for the people is yung susundan natin kung ano ang aral ng ating Panginoon, kung ano ang aral ng ating simbahan. Pag sinabi ng simbahan na ito ay hindi natin na dapat gagawin, dapat siguro pinag-aaral natin mabuti yan kung dapat niya susundin.
But then that's not the separation of church and state.
No, that's really a separation of church and the state. Kasi ang sinasabi lamang sa pagkakahiwalay ng church and the state, yung ang pondo ng gobyerno ay hindi mo pwedeng ibigay para sa isang particular religion.
So are you trying to say that's what you believe, the definition of church and state?
Yes, yun ang pagkakaintindi ko sa separation ng church and state.
It's just yung pondo ng gobyerno, hindi ibigay sa simbahan?
Hindi mo pwedeng pakialaman, hindi pwedeng pakialaman ng Estado ang ginagawa ng simbahan, at ang simbahan din naman, hindi rin niya pwedeng pakialaman ang ginagawa ng Estado, kundi dapat magkakaroon silang proper coordination, kundi igagalang mo ang paniniwala, paninindigan ng bawat isa.
Pero ang tanong ko ngayon, if you were a senator, I mean, may pondo ng gobyerno na dapat nakalaan. para sa mga condom at pills at iba pang mga contraception na nasa barangay health centers for free. Uh-huh. Sasang-ayon ka ba
doon? Yun nga ang aking hindi na sinasang-ayunan. Na itong mga pondong ito ay hindi dapat ginagawa para sa mga bagay na yan. Sapagkat ako hindi naniniwala na yung RH bill ay dapat pinatutupad sa ating bansa.
But then how would you control the population if you were a senator? What other options would you
have given? Well, may mga option din naman tayo na yung proper family planning. Yung pagbibigay sa kanila ng kung paano ikokontrol ang population, hindi naman sa pamamagitan lamang ng paggamit ng mga condom o mga contraceptives, mamaiiwasan yan. Mm-hmm. Ano? So maraming pag-aaral na maaaring gawin. There is no short-term solution to that. Kailangan dito ang mahabang pag-aaral ng ating pamahalaan.
So if you were a senator, divorce is out of the question?
Yes, para sa akin, hindi ako pabor sa divorce. Hindi iyan makakapagbigay ng magandang sa ating pamilya.
Oo. So, divorce is out of the question. If you were a senator, same-sex marriage would be out of the question?
Yes, sa akin. Hindi ako pabor dyan. Pero, ginagalang ko ang kanilang pagsasamahan. Ginagalang ko yung kanilang paniniwala. Pero, so far as I am concerned, hindi ako payag sa divorce. Hindi ako naniniwala na sa pamamagitan ng divorce ay maayos ang isang pamilya. Kailangan ng pagsamahan ay talaga naayos sa... Pangaral ng ating simbahan, ako'y niniwala sa pangaral ng ating simbahan na hindi kailangan ng divorce. Maaring meron tayong mga petition for annulment. Mm-hmm. Ano, the petition for annulment, naririyan yan under the Constitution, under the law.
Okay. Now, moving forward to same-sex marriage, you said no.
Okay.
But then all over the world, we're seeing LGBTQI rights, LGBT rights that are being addressed by governments all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
How would you help the LGBT community kung nanalo po kayong
senador? Well, ang sinasabi ko nga, iginagalang ko ang kailang paniniwala. While hindi ako pumapayag ng same-sex marriage, kung ngayon gusto nilang pagsamahan, wala tayong magagawa dyan. Alam mo yung marriage...
But what would you provide for them under the law? Kasi if you're a senator, you'd have to watch over the rights of everyone. Those who have less in life should have more in the law. Uh-huh. So, ang tanong ngayon, would you be a senator just for the Catholics?
No,
or will Romy Mac be a senator for all?
For the entire people. Ano? Sapagkat pag kaya tumakbo, yan naman ay para sa lahat. Ano
so,
ba?
What would you ang give the kasi, LGBT community?
Well, I respect the rights. Kung talaga may lumabas na batas after a particular debate in the Senate or in the House, a law is passed, then we have to abide by the law.
But would you vote for it?
Oh, I will not vote for it, for the same-sex marriage. Yun ang aking position. But, igagalang ko po ang karapatan ng bawat isa. At igagalang ko ang anumang batas na ilalabas nila. Sapagkat kung nandiyan batas, wala tayong magagawa. A law is passed, and we have to implement the law. We have to respect the law.
Oh. So clearly, I mean, your faith has a lot of influence in how you will choose. I'm curious when it comes to the death penalty. Mm-hmm. You also have Senator Manny Pacquiao, who's pro-death penalty but has actually quoted several verses in the Bible saying that the death penalty was practiced. Where do you stand?
Well, sa akin, hindi ako pabor sa death penalty. My stand is that it's not the severity of the penalty that will deter criminality. Ano? It is how the justice system work. Kailangan ng ating justisya ay talaga na-implement ng tama. Mm-hmm. Ang problema sa atin kasi dito, napakahaba ng ating proseso. Kaya sa ganyan, hindi rin na nawawala itong mga criminal na ito. Oo. Hindi sila natatakot sapagkat ang ating batas ay napakatagal bago ito ma-implement.
Is this because of the stand of the Catholic Church against the death penalty?
Not really because of the Catholic Church, but it is also my firm belief that death penalty is not proper penalty that could be imposed against a heinous crime. Hindi po pwede sabihin na, death penalty kagad yan. Kasi ang ating justice system, sinasabi ko, naku, napakahirap. Okay. Napakatagal bago ma-resolve.
You've also been quite popular, this is interesting, because you've called on all Catholics,
mm-hmm.
and not many candidates do this. You've called on all Catholics to defend the faith.
Yes.
Amid attacks against the Catholic Church, all right? But, let me ask you, it's also in recent years when no less than Pope Francis has addressed the sexual abuses of priests mm-hmm. all over the world and said it is wrong, it should be acted upon. Eto tanong ko, mm-hmm. if a priest has been proven, meron kang biktima, tumanda na, if a priest has been proven to have committed a sexual offense against a child serving mm-hmm. in church, dapat ba makulong ang paring yon like an ordinary citizen?
Dapat. Kasi ang batas natin ay walang tinitingnan kung ikaw ay pare o hindi ka pare. Ano? If you have committed the crime, then you must go to jail. Our penal system is very clear. Any person who commits a crime must be imprisoned. Ano? The definition is very clear. Any person is that not, it does not distinguish if you're a clergyman or an ordinary person. Kung talaga napatunayan paring yan, talagang dapat mapon. So at kung ako halimbawa ay lalapitan na isang victim inabuso niya ng pare, hahawa kong kasong yun at patutunayan ko ng pare yung nagkasala. Not because he is a priest, hindi ko na hahawakan ng isang kaso. Kung isang may isang biktima, halimbawa, ng isang pare, hahawakan ko yun at ipa, sasabihin ko na ang pare yan ay talagang dapat na mapulong.
Oo. So kumbaga, ang tanong ko, kunya, let's say may pare naman na suspected of committing a sexual offense against a minor during, let's say, many years back. Would you defend the priest?
Well, I will defend the priest if he will get my assistance. Ano?
You would still?
Yes.
Even if you knew he was guilty?
No, you said suspected.
Okay, no. But
if he is guilty, then I would tell him na you admit the crime and you ask for a lesser penalty.
Okay.
Dapat ganun. Ano? Kasi alam mo ako, as a matter of fact, as a lawyer, pag ang alam ko ang kaso ay hindi talaga mananalo, sinasabihan ko na ganda ng kliyente. I have rejected a lot of cases knowing that the cases are losing cases. Kapag isang kliyente ay lumapit sa akin, sinabi na may kaso siya, I evaluate the facts in the case. And if I know that the case is a losing case, then I advise my client, I don't accept the case.
Okay. Now, President Duterte has hit the Catholic Church several times and its leaders, but you do have his supporters. Some of his supporters do agree that there is basis for the president hitting the Catholic Church, allegations of corruption within the church, allegations of, let's say, even local churches having so much funds and wealth and not sharing it to the poor. I'm not saying it's the truth.
Okay.
I'm saying allegations. I mean, you do have all churches in the Philippines being tax-free. Mm-hmm. We have critics already saying, dapat ba talaga tax-free ang simbahan? Isn't there basis in a way? I mean, you do have at one point yung mga pare taking pajeros, you defended that. Wala bang punto ang Pangulong Duterte sa totoo lang?
Well, merong punto. As a matter of fact, kahit sino may mga punto sila to say something against the priest. But the use of words, para sa akin ay hindi karapat-dapat yun. It's very unpresidential to say na patayin mo yung mga pare, patayin mo yung ganito. Kailangan, huwag ka maniwala kay Jesus Christ. It's very unimpressive to be nailed on the cross. Itong mga ganito mga salita, yan ang talagang para sa akin ay hindi karapat-dapat isang Katoliko. No? At hindi ko matatanggap yan. I don't hate the president because he is the president. I hate the words that he was saying. Yun ang aking pinagtatanggol. Yung aking sinasabi na kailangan panahon na para tayo mga Katoliko ay magkaisa. Tayo ba'y natutuwa doon mga salitang yun? Dahil natin mga nakikinig ngayon, kayo ba'y natutuwa sa mga ganyang mga salita? Tayo ba'y tatawa na lamang yung mga nakikinig sa kanya? Ganun lang ba sasabihin natin? Kailan pa natin pinaglaban ng ating reliyon? Kailan pa natin pinaglaban ng ating Panginoon? Kailan pa natin pinaglaban ng kanyang mga aral?
Now, you became famous as an election lawyer. In fact, I would say you probably are the most famous election lawyer in the country. But, of course, this has pros and cons when it comes to that. I mean, sometime in the back in 2011, you almost technically, I mean, you were one of those chosen to become, you were a possibility to become chairman of COMELEC. Okay, I mean, you, it was a possible appointment on your end. But then Contradaya, this is old research that I read last night, some sectors opposed, went as far as to oppose your possible appointment as chairman of COMELEC. Then Contradaya was leading and said, how could Romy Mac be chosen as chairman of COMELEC when he defended GMA's corruption in the 2004 elections? Eto, tanong ko, balikan natin yun, ha? Balikan natin yun. Kilo Garci, no less than former President Arroyo, saying, I am sorry for making that call. Do you believe that GMA did not commit an election offense? Walang dayaan during the presidential elections?
Well, noong presidential election, there was no evidence proven. Ano? As a lawyer, we base our handling of the case on the evidence presented in any given case.
But was it wrong? Was that wrong for her to call Garciliano?
It was wrong. It was inappropriate for the president.
Was it against the law?
It was not against the law. It was not? There's nothing against the law. And as a matter of fact, not only the president was the one calling Garci, it was proven that a lot of government officials, elected officials, have been calling Garciliano. So what's the difference between the president and other government officials calling a commissioner of the COMELEC? In the case of the president, what I recall is that she called Garciliano because there was something wrong in she felt that there was something wrong in the count in Mindanao. Mm-hmm. And I think she was just like an ordinary candidate, she was
concerned
that the votes would not be affected by some alleged irregularities there.
So it was not in order, but don't you consider that, I mean, such a conflict? Well,
it was inappropriate. As a matter of fact, even the president, she made an apology, and I was consulted when she made that apology.
You were?
Yes, I was consulted, and my first advice was for the president to admit that there was really a call coming from Garciliano. And my advice was heeded by the president. As a matter of fact, part of the speech I also made, some portions came from my suggestions.
Uh-oh.
At ako'y naniniwala noon na sa pamamagitan ng kanyang pag-amin, matis mawawala yung impression na talaga nagkaroon ng dayaan. Then an election protest was filed against her, and the election protest covers a lot of provinces.
Uh-oh.
And but not only an election protest was filed against the president, even Loren Ligarda filed an election protest against Noli Di Castro, who was then the vice presidential bet of Gloria Arroyo. Mm-hmm. And the protest of Loren Ligarda was just a copycat or a complete, a total reproduction. Kinopya lang niya yung protesta ni Gloria.
No.
Lahat ng provinces. Now, why am I saying this? Because the election protest of Loren Ligarda was dismissed by the Supreme Court for lack of basis. In other words, since the protest of Loren were based on the same protest of Gloria, then there was nothing wrong also with the case of Gloria.
But I think in a way, let's focus on you defending GMA, because in a way, I'd have to say it's really partly what made you know nationwide. Uh-huh. I mean, you do know that.
Well, as a lawyer, you know, she engaged my services.
Yeah.
But I just want to comment on the contradaya allegation.
Yes, I think let's focus on that. Yeah. Never mind Loren and all, because that's not part of your.
First of all, I was just wondering why contradaya would make an opposition to the said proposed appointment.
Yeah,
you know, it was just a suggestion. It was just an offer by President Arroyo. Twice I was offered, but I politely declined. Because sabi ko, hindi ko kaya po yan kasi wala naman akong management skills. I admitted that I really did not, I was not qualified for that. And as a matter of fact, that was not the only position offered to me.
No.
I was offered to be the Secretary of DOJ.
Are you serious?
I was offered to be a Solicitor General. And the last appointment that I received was Chairman of the PNOC. Would you believe? I said, I cannot accept the position PNOC because even the definition of PNOC, I don't know. Hindi ko nga alam kung ano ibig sabihin ng PNOC.
No, but I think what you're trying to say is even if you were Gloria's lawyer and you made her win in that case, is you were decent enough to turn down rewards through positions.
Precisely.
And not many people turn it down. Marami, they take it.
Alam mo, even si Secretary Ermita noon, pinagtatawanan niya ako, ano ka ba, ang dami nakalinya dyan. Lahat sila naghihingi ng appointment na yan. You know, sinabi pa nga sa akin ni President Arroyo, I want you to be the chairman of the COMELEC, then I could appoint you sa DOJ or Solgen and even Justice of the Supreme Court. Ano sinabi ko kay President Arroyo, ma'am, kahit po Chief Justice ng Supreme Court, hindi ko po pinapangarap yan. Because I just want to be an election lawyer. I don't want to be involved in any controversial position.
Okay, so
and
what
imagine,
I asked you...
PNOC, lahat pinapangarap yan.
Oo.
But I politely declined that position.
Okay, no, but very quickly, why run for the Senate? I asked you, you could have probably asked help from House Speaker Gloria Macapagal Arroyo to run for Congress.
Well, ako kasi hindi ako mahilig humingi ng tulong eh. Kung alam naman nilang tumatakbo ko, baka naman sakali mag-volunteer sila. Ano, ha? Pero yung mag-a-approach ako para magkaroon ako ng halimbawa ng utang na loob, yun ang iniiwasan ko. And even yung mga kaibigan ko, mga businessmen, mga lumalapit sa akin, sabi ko, hindi, tatakbo ako ng wala akong budget talaga. I really don't have a budget. Katunayan nung unang ma-interview ako dito ano ni Christian Esguerra, I told him, ang budget ko lang ay 5 million pesos.
Wow.
Are you running for barangay captain? Sabi niya. Pero talaga hanggang ganun lang, Karen. Kasi para sa akin, gusto kong padama sa taong bayan. Ako isang kandidato, I give you an alternative.
Yeah.
Ako ho ay narito para maglingkod. Ano ha? May honesty, may integrity. Wala naman kayo masasabi sa akin. Kaya lagi kong sinasabi, you save your last vote for me and you save your last vote for honesty and integrity. Yan ang lagi kong sinasabi. Paniniwala sa poong may kapal, nakikiusap ako sa inyo, magkaisa tayo. Kapag Catholic vote, hindi ko sinasabi, ako ang dalhin ninyo, kundi magkaisa tayo na patunayan na mamimili tayo ng tunay at na mahusay na mga kandidato. Ako, hindi ako, wala ako masyadong tarpulin, ano? Hindi tayo marunong kumanta, hindi tayo marunong magsayaw, pero nariyan po tayo para maglingkod sa taong bayan.
All right, Romy Mac, I know you have a flight also,
yes,
and so. I do hope you can come back one of these days. We'll be discussing, which you did already though in the ABS-CBN debate.
Okay.
You talked about your passion, your advocacy for senior citizens.
Oh, yes, so.
But I do hope later on you can come back and we can focus on that.
Because we have a lot of programs for our
senior citizens.
So what
is your number in voting?
What, number
in the ballot, I'm sorry.
41. Yeah.
41, Romy Mac.
Sabi ko nga lagi,
you have a safe flight.
Tatanda at lilipas din ako. Ngunit may mga batas akong gagawin para sa iyo.
Okay, all right. Now,